behind-the-scenes work, especially when a film is going on the floors, is one of the most underappreciated and taxing portfolios. From hiring a director of photography, costume designers, choreographers, music directors, etc. Where these individuals that I've already mentioned play key roles and are appreciated for their craft, a lot of people don't understand how important it is to cast the right talent for the characters in movies. Where there are actors who can immerse themselves in any role, no matter how different it is from their personality or upbringing, like Vidya Balan can easily do Ishqe and then go on to do The Dirty Picture. Similarly, a Ranveer Singh can do Alauddin Khilji in Padmavat and go on to do a Murad from Gully Boy. However, a lot of other actors can't really be chameleons. Honestly, there can be only room in the world for so many Joaquin Phoenixes or Christian Bales. And therefore, some of the moments in the roles that I'm going to mention, you cannot disassociate from the actor portraying the role. These roles came across as uncomfortable and totally off with respect to what the characters represented. Discussing just some of the horrifying casting decisions in Hindi films, here is Tried&Refused Productions with top 5 worst Bollywood movie casting decisions that ruined movies. Imran Khan in Matru Ki Bijli Ka Mandola, a movie that had a lot of potential but did not get its due credit because of several facets of it not working, was the 2013 Vishal Bharadwaj directed film Matru Ki Bijli Ka Mandola. The movie had an extremely offbeat and hilarious premise. A businessman in a village that has the best interest of the villagers and their land when he's drunk, but on the opposite spectrum is shrewd and conniving the moment he is sober. Withdrawal leads for him to hallucinate and envision a pink cow, and the politics that follows with corrupt officials and the man's drinking problem was definitely one hell of a ride. Harry's right-hand man Matru was played by Imran Khan. This was the time where the actor was regularly featuring in films. But other than Kidnap, this was his most challenging role. The movie, which is set in Mandola village in Haryana, has its primary character sporting a Haryanvi accent, which Khan struggled with throughout the film. Despite doing law from JNU, the character switched back and forth from sounding like an educated urban youth, enunciating each letter of words, and then would jarringly switch to rolling his tongue, trying to perform the local accent. Imran's underwhelming performance in the film became a sad sight to witness, as Pankaj Kapoor, who shared so many scenes with him, was simply flawless. Whenever Khan ventured into experimenting with character roles outside the simple leading romantic role, it has definitely been quite underwhelming. Shraddha Kapoor in Haseena Parker. The most unintentionally hilarious film of recent times was the 2017 Apoorva Lakhia directed film Haseena Parker. The movie, which is based on Dawood Ibrahim's late and mysterious sister with the same name, was a slog of a film. More than Shraddha Kapoor being inept at playing the role of the infamous Don's sister, the actor was marred by silly writing, atrocious makeup, and inconsistent character development. The individual that had a ton of influence in Nagpada, in real life was heading many operations, including cable operations, the slum development authority, and the Hawala racket. However, the film barely gave us any information of what Haseena is actually doing. The character transitions from being a timid and scared young girl to being a cutthroat and daunting individual, but we barely understood that arc throughout the film. Plastered with bronzer, which often changed color as the movie progressed, it was tough to take the puffed up cheeks and monotone dialogue delivery seriously. Even though it was commendable for the actor to take up such an unconventional role as a challenge, I feel the creative decision to execute and be satisfied to portray the protagonist this way led for the actor to dig her own grave, leading for the role to be mocked at rather than appreciated. John Abraham in Welcome Back. Kartik Aaryan will find it very tough to fill the shoes of Akshay Kumar with the second installment of Bhool Bhulaiya. I just hope and wish it doesn't turn out to be a train wreck. That was the 2015 film Welcome Back. Welcome, the 2007 film, was an absolutely hilarious movie, despite its over-the-top turn of events and premise. It showcased an iconic duo of Majnu and Uday, the funniest back and forth between an eccentric character like Gungru, and a quest for basically survival in the end as a menacing yet hilarious villain RDX comes into the picture. Welcome Back, on the other hand, was nothing but a cringe fest. I've come to the conclusion that John Abraham is ideal for intense roles, being most appreciated for films like Force, New York, Madras Cafe, and Parmanu. The track record of his comedic roles in his filmography proved that the funny bone is definitely missing in the actor. Even more so, the premise and execution of the film is so bizarre that you wonder why even the actor said yes to the role. Well, it might be the money. Here is just a list of the absurd scenes in the movie. Shooting in the air and crows coming on command to torment characters, primarily all the scenes being shot on a green screen, or I don't know, jumping over camels in the last scene. The lead role, the writing, the screenplay, everything was a mess. The reason for the film to be considered a semi-hit is only due to the nostalgic value of the original. Ajay Devgan in London Dreams. You know what's necessary for a movie beyond its story, especially if it's focusing on musicians? That the music is memorable and timeless. Everyone remembers Sadda Haq from Rockstar and Meri Laundry Ka Ek Bill from Rock On. Name me one song that you still jam to from the 2009 film London Dreams. Yeah. I thought so. A movie which is so melodramatic and has lack of substance also suffered from trying to make audiences believe that Ajay Devgan is a rock star that is loved by the masses and is going to headline in Wembley Stadium. The problem is that Devgan didn't embody even the body language of a musician at the top of his game. Rather than that, the actor looked mostly awkward in his portrayal of the insecure, ambitious, yet talented musician Arjun. Salman Khan, surprisingly as Mannu, was the highlight of the film, an inherently talented but lost singer. It's sad to say, but it's true, that the shades, the designer jackets, and multiple piercings could not really convince audiences of this character portrayed by Devgan. Kamal R. Khan in Ek Villain. When everything is perfect in the film, why do creators want to surprise us with something that we never wanted? Ek Villain, the remake of the South Korean film I Saw the Devil, showcased some formidable performances by the actors. An unconventional role by Ritesh Deshmukh playing the disturbed antagonist on a killing spree, Siddharth Malhotra as the stoic and vengeful guru, and a praiseworthy emotional portrayal of Aisha by Shraddha Kapoor. The antagonist Rakesh is in an emotionally abusive relationship and surrounds himself with the worst company possible. Who is that company? None other than Kamal R. Khan playing the role of Brijesh, a man who beats up his wife, loves to cheat on her, and keeps on reminding Rakesh what a loser he truly is. The performance is loud, crass, and cringy to witness. How could the audience even forget Brijesh is the same guy who did this on a reality TV show? And that was a video, guys. Write down in the comments below if you have some video ideas for our channel. Please don't forget to follow me on Instagram. The handle is right in front of you. Follow me at JammyPants4. Also, please support us by smashing the like button and subscribing to our channel for weekly content ahead. Thank you for watching.